Welcome to the APE conference, and you have no doubt that I'm a German, as Arnold Kemp is a Dutch, and you heard it from my accent. But I try hard not to spoil my pronunciation and to become too English. I try hard to stay German. A turbulent year lies behind us. The economic crisis caused incoming orders to decline all over the world and also affected our business, although it seems less hard hit than others. Perhaps also because 2009 was for publishers just another year of a transformation which the enterprises have already been going through for a long time now. The transition from physical to digital distribution has already begun. A survey by the German Publishers Booksellers Association's Working Group for Electronic Publishing, that is official name, shows that 37% of new issues in a year already appear exclusively or additionally as an e-book. This is particularly true for the scientific and specialist publishers, where the e-book proportion of new issues already reaches 51%. But at the same time, almost 80% of publishers say that e-books account for less than 1% of their total sales. So the publishers, ladies and gentlemen, are well equipped. It is a market that still needs to develop. Thank you for that applause. At the end of last year, the world's largest online bookseller announced that for the first time it sold more e-books than printed books on the first Christmas day in the United States. At the same time, Kindle, Amazon's strongest selling e-book reader, is now available worldwide, also in Germany. With a Nook, Barnes & Noble also started with an own reader for the Christmas business and is striving to catch up in the fight for the new market. But what the readers all too often find lacking are matching content. So it is high time to create the foundations for providing digital content. In Germany, the book trade resellers and publishers have unanimously backed the sector platform Librica last year, so that this service started with a new year, with a new momentum. And I hope it has a chance against Google. On another market, the science and specialist publishers have for a long time been proving how electronic publishing can work. Selling access to databases through flexible license models is a generally accepted and technically matured process in specialist and scientific publishing. Nevertheless, copyright problems are there. This shows the ruling of the Frankfurt am Main High Regional Court in 2009 in the litigation between the Darmstadt University and State Library and the publisher Eugen Ulmer concerning the use of copyright books for digital purposes without a licensing fee. The ruling brought some legal certainty, but the harsh reaction of the German Library Association also shows that we have only gone a short way along a common path. And Google? The settlement in its original form is history. And a part of the demand by the German Publishers and Booksellers Association has been realized. The new Google book settlement only still affects books that were either registered in the US copyright register at the Library of Congress in Washington and are therefore considered as United States copyright works, or they were published in Canada, Australia, or in the United Kingdom. According to the new scope of application definition by far most of books published in Germany are thus no longer covered by the Google Book Settlement and part of success, but I don't know, and the success in the end. But Google is expanding its offer. With the introduction of Google Edition, a complete distribution model for digital content, and including the Google Book Search, the search engine operator underlines its ambitions to expand business with digital content, and this strengthens our resolve here in Germany to continue very hard working on alternatives, as Librica might be, in order to prevent a content monopoly, which is a real and great danger. These current developments show that the framework conditions for rapidly advancing digitalization in our sector are increasingly given. For us all, publishers, booksellers, librarians, resellers, as well as authors, the question will arise about contents for future forms of books and periodicals. Because these contents, the preparation and marketing, are going to change just as much as their carriers have already partly changed. We are all challenged to make our contribution to new forms of electronic publishing and to make sure that it will, also in the future, be our business. The fact that we now meet here for the fifth time underlines the sustainability of digitization, the vehemence of the changes we are witness to, and the significance of the academic publishing conference in Europe. This year, dear scientists, librarians, and publishers, you are literally at the focal point of this event. Nevertheless, all of us probably still have to find our roles in scientific communication in the digital age, and the title, researchers, librarians, and publishers, and their roles in scholarly communications, is a reminder that we may not be merely witnesses in these sweeping changes, but that we will need to take an active role in shaping the new possibilities and shaping our new roles. In this spirit, may I welcome you to the APA conference again, which will dedicate itself this year to the challenges I've already outlined, for example, as three themes. What do the researchers and those who found them expect from the library and the publisher today and the future? And Google and friends, what is the new world of digital libraries? And what are the articles of the future? These are just three of very many pressing questions in the event program and which we should discuss together. Because, as the conference title implies, only in unity shall we be able to confront these gigantic challenges posed by digitization. It only remains now for me, as the chairman of the publishing committee of the German Publishers and Booksellers Association, representing booksellers, publishers, and distributors here in Germany, as well as a legal publisher in my own right, experiencing the transformation from day to day. So I appeal again, let us shape the coming days and the future together. But it should not be taken for granted that this will be possible in such a high-level international roundtable and agreeable settings. We also owe our deepest thanks to the organizers, above all Arno de Kemp, who have once again made the preparations for two very substantial days. I may add, for me, Mr. de Kemp is something like the Harry Potter of our business, because it needs magic powers to bring a lot of people in this time in cold Berlin to discuss together and not in Sevilla or Athens. And now I wish us many new insights, some enjoyment, and perhaps making new friends in new roles.